Cost of goods sold, or COGS tracking, is a feature inside of Link My Books that allows you to keep a track of all of the costs of the units that were sold as part of a specific settlement. How the COGS feature works. For each payout settlement from a sales channel, we'll sum up the total monetary value of all products that were sold as part of that payout period. We use this figure to generate an entry to be sent to your bookkeeping platform, which in effect moves that value from an inventory asset account on your balance sheet into a cost of goods sold account on your profit and loss. In Xero, that would look something like this. Let's break down each of the lines for clarity. Line one, the inventory deduction from fulfillment by Amazon FBA, is the COGS figure being deducted from an asset account, in this case, Amazon inventory. Line two, cost of goods sold fulfillment by Amazon FBA, is the COGS figure being added to the direct costs account, in this case, Amazon cost of goods sold. The entry we create will always net off to zero because in effect, all we are doing is moving the balance of that figure from the inventory account to the cost of goods sold account and they cancel each other out. How to set up and turn on the COGS feature. When you turn on our cost of goods sold tracking feature, there's a few things that you're gonna need to set up in order for it to work properly. Step one, enter your product costs. On the product costs page, which is linked below this video, you'll need to enter the landed cost of each of the products that you sell. You can do this directly on the page itself, or if you've got lots of products, you can use our bulk upload option. The cost you enter for each of your products entirely depends on how you're accounting for things at the moment. If, for example, you're accounting for your landed cost as the product cost that you pay to your supplier, plus any shipping costs to get it from your supplier to Amazon's warehouse, for example, plus any import duties, then the landed cost should reflect all of these things on a per unit basis. For example, if the product cost that you pay to your supplier is £5.50 and the shipping cost is 18 pence and the duty is 40 pence, then the amount you should enter as your landed cost in Link My Books is £6.08. If, however, you only account for the product cost you pay to the supplier to your inventory account currently, and all your other costs like shipping and duty are accounted for in separate accounts in Xero or QuickBooks, then you should take that into account. In our example we've just given, that would mean that the cost you would enter in Link My Books would be £5.50 instead of £6.08. Step two, turn on the COGS tracking feature and select your cost of goods sold and inventory asset account. When you turn on the cost of goods sold tracking feature via the settlement settings page, you'll be prompted to select a credit account and a debit account. Your credit account is your inventory asset account. This is the account that you'll use when you purchase goods from your supplier. Your debit account is the account we'll use for cost of goods sold as the items are being sold. If you haven't already got an inventory asset account or a cost of goods sold account set up in your current chart of accounts, then turning on these and accepting our defaults will add them into your existing chart of accounts. For Amazon accounts, you'll need to select an inventory asset and a cost of goods sold account for each of the different fulfillment types. You can, of course, use the same account for each of the fulfillment types if you wish to. For eBay, Shopify, and Etsy accounts, however, there is only one account to select for your inventory asset and one for your cost of goods sold. Once you've completed the two steps above, we will automatically refresh all of your settlements that haven't already been sent to your bookkeeping platform. And then if you view those settlements via the view icon on the action menu from the settlements dashboard, you'll see that there's now a new cost of goods sold tab and it has some data in it. Once COGS is turned on, when you click the Send Settlement button from the main dashboard, we will automatically post your sales and fees invoice plus this COGS entry as well. To use the cost of goods sold tracking feature, you'll need to do these three things. Firstly, enter your product costs. Secondly, you'll need to turn on cost of goods sold tracking. And thirdly, you'll need to select an inventory asset account and a cost of goods sold account in order for everything to work. You'll also need to take note that every time you purchase inventory, you'll need to use the same inventory asset account that you've chosen in Link My Books in order to top up your balance sheet with your new inventory. Think of this as every time you purchase inventory, you're topping up your inventory asset account on the balance sheet. And then as that inventory is being sold, Link My Books is automatically moving the value of that inventory that was sold from the inventory asset account into your cost of goods sold account, meaning that we are reducing the amount of inventory showing on your balance sheet, and we are increasing the cost of that inventory on your profit and loss report.